When we think about the future of civilization, we know that technological development isn't always a straightforward path. And naturally, it can be tricky to visualize anything that's further along it, anything that's more advanced than us. Our brightest minds have given it some thought, though. And for one John D. Barrow, the key is to strive for mastery over smaller and smaller worlds. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if humanity was a Type 3-minus civilization?
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
The most famous scale towards advanced civilization is, of course, the Kardashev Scale. It was invented as a means to quantify and measure the degree of advancement that any civilization could hypothetically achieve, and has therefore become an influential tool when we consider the possibilities for extraterrestrial life. By making predictions about what technology different levels or types might be capable of, we can guide how to better search for them in space. Nikolai Kardashev, the scale's creator, focused on energy potential. A Type 1 can harness all the energy of its home planet. With Type 2, it's all the energy of its home star system. With Type 3, it's home galaxy. And there are extensions for types 4, 5, and so on, the universe, multiverse, etc. However, though the Kardashev scale is certainly popular, it isn't without its drawbacks. For example, it doesn't apply equally to all prospective groups, i.e., planets in the same star system will all reach Type 1 at different times, based on their individual size, orbit, distance from star, and so on. But the parameters for all those worlds to reach Type 2 are then the same again. There's also some criticism of the seeming rigidity of the Kardashev scale, when in real life it seems as though the levels should inevitably mix, so that a civilization might use some Type 2 technologies before fully becoming even a Type 1, for instance. Again, technological development isn't always so straightforward a path. As such, a number of different scales have been put forth as alternatives. The popular physicist Carl Sagan, for one, thought up a revised model based on the information content any given society is able to store, and Sagan ranked his arguably more nuanced scale from A to Z. However, in this case, humanity is already past the halfway mark in Sagan's alphabet, so perhaps it's too limited. Elsewhere, the science fiction author Arthur C. Clarke also created a scale in his writing, based this time on what forms of technology a people can use, moving from stone to metal and so on. But Clarke's model has never really truly rivaled the Kardashev scale in real-world academic study. That breakthrough has been achieved with John Barrow's scale, however. An acclaimed astrophysicist, Barrow proposed an almost reverse Kardashev scale, where civilizations are ranked based on how small of an object they can manipulate. It's called the Microdimensional Scale, and it measures advancement in Type Minus categories. A Type 1 Minus, for example, is like base camp. It can manipulate the world around it as we see it by digging tunnels and constructing buildings. A Type 2 Minus delves deeper, though, into the unseen, so that it can control genes and biological bodies. And today's focus, a Type 3 minus, can manipulate molecules on a fundamental level. Again, pigeonholing any civilization into these types is difficult, not least with humanity. We've clearly passed Barrow's Type 1 minus already, but at present we haven't conclusively completed any of the next types along. We share some capabilities with both a Type 2 and a Type 3 minus without having totally mastered either of them. Being a full Type 3 minus would still essentially mean doing things that are only possible in science fiction. A Type 3 minus human will have completely mastered gene editing, for example, which means that it could be able to essentially customize human beings and any other biological creature. Genetic code and DNA can be fixed, altered, or even created anew. We'd have immunities against most major diseases and cancers, effective cures for anything that did get through, and quick-fix responses whenever a new germ or pathogen appeared. On the flip side, Type 3 minus humans would likely be part cyborg, with artificial body parts in place of antiquated biological ones. The human capabilities of today will have been enhanced so that on some level we'd have what the modern world considers to be superpowers. With the most fundamental parts of our bodies under scrutiny and open to reinterpretation, the road is short towards things like super strength via modified skeletons, or superintelligence via custom-designed cerebral stimulants. This is also the long-prophesized world of designer babies, where parents can customize exactly how they want their child to look and be. It's also a world where reviving previously extinct species should be possible, so something akin to Jurassic Park might be possible for a Type 3 minus society. A Type 3 minus would have more than just a mastery over biology, however. Although not yet able to manipulate individual atoms, their general molecular control opens countless opportunities for their species. Consider only the reality of temperature, for example. Temperature is based on the motion of molecules. So by controlling the speed of molecules, you could precisely control the ambient climate. One of the key everyday conditions for a comfortable life is totally adjustable for this civilization. On a smaller, less general home-by-home basis, we can visualize it by imagining that today's air conditioning units are universally replaced with molecular control panels. Devices infused with microdimensional know-how so that they enable the user to interact with the very molecules in the room, extracting or adding heat when needed. Combine tech like this with the biological enhancements, and the machines themselves might not even be necessary. With a Type 3 minus capable of simply thinking molecular manipulation, in this case room temperature, into life. While the Barrow scale perhaps isn't as outwardly expansionist as the Kardashev scale, it's still firmly geared towards space travel as well, suggesting various possible solutions to a group's interplanetary goals. For modern-day humans, it's all eyes on Mars, but we know it's inhospitable, not least because it lacks an abundance of water and a breathable atmosphere. These aren't major problems if you're a Type 3 minus, though, as you can easily produce and manipulate the greenhouse gases needed to kickstart the creation of water and atmosphere. It's another example of how a Type 3 minus can effectively customize their key surrounding conditions. If the air isn't immediately breathable when they arrive somewhere, they can move the molecules around until it is. If the water isn't instantly drinkable, they can filter and purify it until it's 100% good for their health. The ability to both control genes and create new materials out of molecules would change how so many industries function. There'd be a revolution in construction and building work, for example, with custom-made, unbreakable materials that are as strong, durable, light, and as efficient as possible. Perhaps there'd be inspiration taken from the natural world here, with homes and buildings made out of something similar to spider silk, for instance, due to its incredible strength. Elsewhere, a similar approach might be used in healthcare settings, where nature again inspires. We know that shark skin is perfectly designed to deflect as many things as possible, like algae, debris, and even bacteria. So Type 3 minus physicians and healers could translate that into either a technology or a body enhancement to help them in their line of work. Sticking with sea life but moving away from the workplace, a Type 3 minus could potentially generate their own gills and so breathe underwater, or manipulate their own eyes to be more like those of the mantis shrimp, which can famously process many times more colors than the human eyeball can. If, say, you wanted to climb walls, you could change your body or the wall to make it happen. Even if you wanted to float or fly, you could theoretically move molecules to push you upwards, to literally walk on air. As well as water, food can be controlled and regulated at the molecular level, which means only the healthiest and tastiest meals all the time. There are potential downsides. In theory, a Type 3 minus society should be equal, but what if it's not? What if some can manipulate food and water, but others can't? What happens if the ability to change the molecular base layer of reality continues on forever untapped? Perhaps a Type 3 minus would need some level of specific policing or governance. But then, would that take away the very freedom that this future reality is built on? For now, we can say that John Barrow didn't end his scale at Type 3 minus. He envisioned that groups could eventually learn to control even smaller worlds. At Type 4 minus, it's mastery over atoms. At Type 5 minus, it's an atom's nucleus. With Type 6, it's elementary particles like quarks. And there's even an Omega civilization that controls the very fabric of space-time itself. On Barrow's third rung, then, there would still be goals ahead of us and improvements to make. It still might not be the perfect world, but we'll have massively progressed along that path of tech development. And that's what would happen if humanity was a Type 3 minus civilization. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled,
and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.